Hello everyone. Already I have explained the component involved in UV visual spectrophotometer, like light source, monochromators like slits, mirrors, filters, after that sample holders and all. Already I have explained. So now we'll see the detectors. There are various type of detectors out there. So device which converts light energy into electrical signal, because we cannot directly read the light energy, how much it absorb and all. So we need a electrical signal that are displayed on readout devices. The transmitted radiation fall on the detector, which determines the intensity of radiation absorbed by the sample. So some detectors are there, like this barrier layer cell or the photovoltaic cell, then phototubes, then photomultiplier tubes. So we'll see the first one, that is barrier layer cell, or you can say photovoltaic cell. The detector has a thin film metallic layer coated with silver or gold and act as an electrode. This detector has a thin film metallic layer coated with the silver or gold, and it is acting as an electrode. It also has a metal base plate which act as another electrode. These two layers are separated by a semiconductor layer of the selenium. Here you can see the selenium, the bottom layer is a base plate. After that we have a selenium layer, and after that we have this transparent layer, and in the above we have this collector ring. When a light radiation fall on the selenium layer, that is this selenium layer, you can see when the light radiation fall on the selenium layer, electrons become mobile and are taken up by the transparent metal layer. The transparent metal layer means the layer above the selenium layer. This creates a potential difference between two electrodes and causes the flow of current. When it is connected to galvanometer, a flow of current observed which is proportional to the intensity and a wavelength of the light falling on it. So here you can see the photo I have given. The selenium is there. Selenium, it is in middle. In above we have a glass, and in between the layer we have a thin layer of the silver. So this is the diagram. After that we have a photo tube, or this photo emissive tube. Here you can see the photo, the light rays are there. Okay, this release electron is attracted to the positive wire. One positive wire is there, one negative is there. Positive wire or plate, here you can see and light sensitive metal surface, and battery is connected with the emitter. This is the photo tube. This is the schematic diagram of this detector. So what is photo tube? It is consists of a evaporated glass tube with a photo cathode and a collector anode, and the surface of the photo cathode is coated with a layer of elements like calcium, silver oxide, or a mixture of them. When the radiant energy fall on a photosensitive cathode, electrons are emitted which are attracted to anode, causing current to flow. So more sensitive compared to barrier layer cell, therefore widely used. And the last one, we have a photomultiplier tube. The principle I have employed in this detector is that the multiplication of the photoelectrons by secondary emission of electron. So in a vacuum tube, a primary photo cathode is fixed which receives radiation from the sample, and some 8 to 10 dianodes are fixed, each with the increasing potential of 75 to 100 volt higher than preceding one, and near the last dianode is fixed an anode or electron collector electron. And lastly, this photo multiplier is extremely sensitive to light and is best suited where weaker or low radiation is received. This is the diagram of the photo multiplier tube. Here you can see this is the schematic diagram from where you can get an idea about this photo multiplier tube detector. So thank you.